Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and other top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 20th of June. India's Jai Shankar unveils project with Sri Lankan President in Colombo. Pakistan breaks up Kashmir, calls it disputed territory after India raises objection. And Taliban labels U.S. support for Afghanistan as attempt to tarnish image ahead of Doha. And now for all the details. India's Foreign Minister S. Jayashankar on Thursday met Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe upon his arrival in Colombo to bolster ties. Both the leaders jointly unveiled the virtual plaque to mark the commissioning of Maritime Rescue Coordination Center, built with a $6 million grant from India. They also virtually handed over 154 houses built under Government of India housing schemes. Notably, it is Jayashankar's first visit abroad after his second consecutive term in office. Jayashankar noted that Sri Lanka is central to India's neighbourhood first and Sagar policies. He later also called on Prime Minister Dinesh Gunawardena and reiterated India's strong support through development and connectivity initiatives. Jayashankar's visit marks India's continued commitment to Sri Lanka being its closest maritime neighbour. And just ahead of Prime Minister's Modi two-day visit to Jammu and Kashmir, security forces on Wednesday neutralized two terrorists in an encounter in Baramulla district. The region has witnessed a spate in terror attacks in recent days. The anti-terror operation was launched based on specific inputs. Officials said both the terrorists were from Pakistan and belonged to Lashkar-e-Taiba group.
19 June 2024 को हमें जम्मू एंड कश्मीर पुलिस से एक स्पेसिफिक इंफॉर्मेशन मिली कि रफियाबाद इलाके के हादीपुर गांव में एक घर में टेररिस्ट दिखाई दिए गए हैं. इसके चलते इंडियन आर्मी, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर पुलिस और सीआरपीएफ ने एक जॉइंट काउंटर टेररिस्ट ऑपरेशन लॉन्च किया और इलाके का फुर्ती से कॉर्डन किया. हमने अपने प्रोसीजर के मुताबिक सभी आसपास के घरों में पहले जो सिविलियंस थे उनको सेफली इवैक्यूएट किया और उन घरों को सिक्योर किया. उसके बाद टारगेट हाउस पे हमने अपना कॉर्डन टाइट किया और इस दौरान सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस पे टेररिस्ट का फायर आया. जवाबी कार्रवाई में दोनों टेररिस्ट मार गिराए गए.
Meanwhile, in a major breakthrough in the terror attack on a bus in Jammu and Kashmir's Riasi district earlier this month, police have arrested a suspected overground worker believed to be the prime suspect for facilitating and giving logistic support to the militants in the attack. At least 10 pilgrims were killed while several others were injured after their bus was ambushed by terrorists and it fell into a gorge. The police have reportedly detained 150 people so far for questioning. Islamabad on Wednesday raked up Kashmir as it replied to the concern raised by New Delhi over mention of Kashmir in the joint statement by China and Pakistan issued following Pak PM Shehbaz Sharif's visit to Beijing. In a statement, Pakistan's Foreign Ministry spokesperson Mumtaz Zahra Baloch said India has no right for objection over the reference made in the joint statement. Calling the region as disputed territory, Baloch said the matter has been on UN Security Council's agenda for last 7 decades and added New Delhi should implement the relevant UNSC resolutions in the region. The comments come a week after New Delhi raised objection on reference of the Indian territory of Jammu and Kashmir in the joint statement between China and Pakistan and reiterated the region of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh have been are and will always remain integral and inalienable part of India. Claimed by both New Delhi and Islamabad, India and Pakistan have fought multiple wars over Kashmir region. New Delhi maintains it is an integral part of India and Islamabad has no locus standi on it. Former government employees in Pakistan occupied Jammu and Kashmir have continued to stage a sit-in protest to demand a 100% hike in their pensions. They accuse the Pakistan government of being apathetic towards their plight amid rising inflation.
Scores of former government employees and pensioners in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir have been holding a sit-in protest to demand 100% hike in their pensions. The protesters lamented, amid soaring inflation, it has become difficult to manage household expenses. But Islamabad remains apathetic towards their plight. They said they have held several demonstrations over the past 1 year, but bureaucratic blockade has delayed the process.
इस कमर तोड़ महंगाई में हम ये कहना चाहते हैं कि यहाँ पेंशन में 100% इजाफा किया जाना चाहिए अलाज मुआवजे के लिए हमें जो एलपी ने बंद कर दिया है वो कर देनी चाहिए पेंशन इस्लाह के नाम पर इन्होंने हुकूमत पाकिस्तान ने ऐसे इकदाम जो हैं वो शुरू किए हुए हैं जिससे वो कहते हैं पेंशन बोझ है पेंशन बोझ नहीं है बल्कि करप्शन बोझ है इस मुल्क
मसाइल तो वो हैं वो मामला तो वो हैं जो पाकिस्तान की सतह पे सब लोगों को इसका इस्तेफादा मिल रहा है और आज़ाद कश्मीर के लोग इससे मुस्तफीद नहीं हो रहे ये हुकूमत की इंतहाई बेइज्जती है जिसकी हम शदीद तौर पर मजम्मत भी करते हैं
The protesters blamed instead of providing any aid to the people in the occupied region. Economic losses faced by Pakistan are also being compensated from territories under its illegal control.
Days ahead of Taliban's first participation in the UN meeting over Afghanistan, the de facto authorities have labeled the world body's latest report on human rights an attempt to tarnish perception before the meeting. Talking to Tolo News, Taliban spokesperson Zabiullah Mujahid said the reports by some members of the United Nations, especially the report by Richard Bennett, is an attempt to mislead minds ahead of the Doha meeting. Some individuals with grudges in the United Nations always try to present incorrect reports about Afghanistan, he added. The response came a day after Richard Bennett, the UN Special Rapporteur on Afghanistan, warned that Taliban's pattern of systematic violations of women's fundamental rights has intensified, causing immense harm spanning generations and all elements of society in the country. Bennett said that violations are so severe and extensive that they may amount to crimes against humanity. Since seizing power in 2021, Taliban swiftly began curtailing women's rights, including imposing stricter dress codes, banning higher education for girls, excluding women from employment, and restricting freedom of movement in public spaces. And the flood situation in Sylhet in Bangladesh has worsened as torrential rains have left thousands of people marooned in the northeastern region, still recovering from a cyclone that hit the country's coastal belt last month. Officials said more than 5 lakh people have been affected by the flood in Sylhet and neighbouring Sunam Ganj, with water levels surpassing danger levels at 6 points along 4 rivers in the region. Meanwhile, at least 10 people, including 8 Rohingya Muslims, were reportedly killed in rain-triggered landslides in refugee camps in southern Bangladesh. The weather office has forecast heavy rains to continue for the next few days.
যে মালিকৰ গৰ খয় খতি হৈছে আমাৰ এখন একটু আছে এ গৰৰ মাল কিছু নিছন গিয়ে অন্য ভাষা জিনা জিনা সিটি কৰ্পোৰেশ্যনে কেউ আমাৰ একু সালো আইছোন না এখন কেউ আইয়া এখন দেখছোন না
ভাষা মাঝে থাকতে পারতাছি না ভাষার মাঝে আডু পানি খাওয়া খাদ্য খাইতে পারতাছি না রান্দা বাড়াও করতে পারতাছে না সমস্যা ব্যবসার দোকানপাট বন্ধ হয়ে যাইতেছে বুঝছেন অনেক ব্যবসা করতে পারতেন আটাচরাও করতে পারতেছি না বাচ্চা নিয়ে খুবই সমস্যা আছে ভাইয়া
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.